In this tutorial, I would like to show you how you can really design a normal presentation slide. A slide with an image, with some icons and useful information. A very generic slide which will work with any type of presentation. Okay, let's start this design. As you can see, I have one image and four icons. And let's say that I want to use some icons in this slide and I want it to have both the image and a secondary color. So I'll delete everything and I'll start by working the image. I'll place the image in the design and I see this is a pretty big image. I would like it, however, to cover the left side. Since this is a very generic image and it doesn't matter if it's more to the left or more to the right, so I'll just place it here. If I would like to be exactly in the middle, I would go to view and open up the guides, and now I see from the guide where the middle is, and I'll decide that in the moment. So let me hit on crop. Okay, at first I want to crop it to at least the middle of the slide. Or maybe the middle is a bit too much. Let's go a bit forward, so we have a bit above the middle. And now we can shift the actual image. I think those buildings look cool, especially the front here is okay. And it should be visible, because else it would be too much buildings. Now the composition looks quite cool. Okay, crop. Boom, we have the left side of our slide. Now the right side and one element from it should be one strong color. The way I'm going to do this is by selecting Insert, Shapes, and I'll insert a shape. I'll take a shape, a rectangle shape, and I'll make it like that. Now I want to make equal spaces here on the top side and here on the bottom side. The simplest way to achieve that is to use the align options. I'll click on align and I'll align it middle. Okay, now I'm perfectly sure that those are equal. Now I want to make it bigger, to about this extent. Okay, or maybe like this. Perfect. Shape outline. No outline, shape fill, and now I need to decide on my color. And let's maybe go this time with an orange, and I'll pick a strong orange, a really strong one. Okay. Well, that's definitely very strong, but if it will not work, I'll change it later. And now please click on the right object and select Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. If you are on a Mac, it will be of course Command-C and V. Okay, now I take this shape, I make it smaller on this side, and you see, that's what I want to achieve. I want it to be a bit transparent. So right click, Format Shape, click on Fill, and immediately you see the transparency. I'll make the transparency to 40%. Seems very nice, it looks good. We can still see the buildings, but we also see this object. And let me go to view, delete guide, and this is my basic slide composition. And I think this already looks very cool. Now I can work with the objects I had. I had the icons, I'll drop all four icons here. And I see some of them are bigger. I don't know why, I thought these are the same, but this doesn't matter. I'll use the icons like that, and I'll just place them on this side. I could place some text under it depending on what I'm designing, but I'll just place the icons here. If you, for example, have very precise icons, you can also select all four of them, go to Format, Align, and distribute them vertically. So now they would be distributed properly. You could, for example, go to Insert again, Shapes, and make backgrounds for the icons. Then you would click on them and you would send them a bit backward, and you would have backgrounds for the images. But I think those icons look standalone very, very cool. I'll shift them a bit to the right side by selecting all of them. Okay, and here I would populate the slide with text. I would just go to Insert, Text Box, and I would slowly start to insert text box. Slide title. Yeah, slide. Slide title. Okay, and give me a second, so I place a few text boxes here around this slide. Now this is just finalizing the slide depending on what you need, and the right side will be the like the main content, and you can use any text. You can, for example, make this bold, then make another text box not bold, smaller one like here, boom, Ctrl V here, or some bullet points. Maybe bullet points would be better here because this is quite much text, but it doesn't matter. I just wanted to show you how you can make a nice slide design like that. So I'm going over this slide by selecting nice icons and one image. This is enough to create a complete slide composition, and we have still a bit of free space, and this free space gives you more freedom with the text, because now I think now the text looks really nice and I can focus on it. I don't have to focus on the entire slide because I know the content is exactly here. The rest is just reinforcements. I do hope you did like this slide tutorial and you will create such slides on your own without problems because it's a really simple design, nice to utilize, and I think it will be useful for any designer's portfolio.